Hello friends, let's briefly understand the history of derivatives. Are derivatives a recent phenomena? How long derivative products have been used? And fundamentally, why did the derivatives product come into existence? As we know, the purpose of derivative products is to help the players hedge their risk of fluctuation in the prices of underlying assets. Various products are being traded across the globe for thousands of years. The international trade is not something new. India, for example, as a civilization, has had trades with countries as far as in Europe and as far as Japan in Southeast Asia. So, trade is not new, trade routes are not new. The global trade required the kind of exchange where commodities were promised to be delivered sometime in future. They'll be produced to maybe after 2 years, 3 years, and you had to have contracts in place to sell them at some time in future. That's why the first derivative contracts that came into existence were forward contracts. The recorded history of derivatives goes as far as back to 12th century Europe, where the wool merchants or producers used to sell wool a couple of years in advance for delivery later. For example, in 13th century, the derivatives market in Europe matured so much that forward trades in wool were being conducted as much as 20 years in advance. So today, the price will be agreed, the amount of wool to be delivered, the quality will be agreed, and the delivery will be made 20 years down the line. In 17th century Japan, we find instances of rice being traded in the futures market. The producers would deliver the rice maybe 2 years down the line, but the agreement will be made today. This was because those times were uncertain times in Japan with China and Japan wars going on, and rice is one of the important food items and also produced a lot in that region. In US, for example, Chicago Board of Trade, Chicago Mercantile Exchange, these and Chicago Board of Options Exchange came into existence in the 19th century. On those exchanges, various commodities, futures and forwards were being traded. Slowly, the currency forwards and futures came into existence as US tried to establish dollar as a reserve currency for trade across the globe. The stock futures and options also started getting traded around the same time. In India, for example, there was a thriving market in the forwards for various commodities like the trading in groundnuts, castor seeds, cotton, gold, silver in the western region around Mumbai. In eastern region around Calcutta, there used to be a thriving trade in jute and jute products. As you can see, these are the products mainly manufactured in or produced in these regions, and that's why there was a thriving market for forward or future trading in these regions. Till about 1939, the forward market was thriving in India. But the British banned forward trading in almost all commodities in 1939, specifically because of the Second World War. The British wanted to take all the produce from India for their use and for financing of the war. So they did not allow any kind of trading to take place in India. Unfortunately, post-independence, we had leaders with socialistic mindset, and they continued the ban on various commodities, trading in futures and forwards, for almost 6 decades. It's only in this century, around 2003, that the derivatives trade really started again taking place in India. In between, on the Mumbai Stock Exchange, there existed Badla and Unda Badla. By Badla, we mean you could pay the charges and postpone taking the delivery of the stocks to the next settlement. So it was something like a call option or futures where you want to buy some commodity or a stock in future. By paying Unda Badla, you could postpone the delivery of the stocks into the next settlement cycle. So this was something close to derivatives that we saw in India before, again, these were legally allowed after coming into existence of Securities and Exchange Board of India. So SEBI had set up various committees to explore how derivatives market can be again thrived in India. So one of the committees that was set up, they recommended that derivatives should be included as securities in SCRA or Securities Contract Regulation Act. because Securities Contract Regulation Act is the fundamental act in India governing the trading of securities in India. The other committees came up with various recommendations. For example, how the margining system for derivatives should work. What should be the membership criteria for members on the stock exchanges who are allowed to deal in derivatives? How the real-time position monitoring is going to happen so that the risk can be contained and the margins can be adequately collected from the brokers and other players. Now we have a market in India where we have index futures options on indexes like Nifty, which is Nifty 50 on National Stock Exchange, or Sensex or BSE Sensex, which is comprising of 30 stocks. There are index and futures on individual stocks, specifically they are allowed on the liquid stocks. And also the Government of India has set up the Metropolitan Stock Exchange of India Limited, specifically focused on trading in derivatives. Today, India has a thriving market in derivatives, with the futures and options segment in NSE and BSE registering good volumes. We have also good market in OTC products, specifically on the fixed income securities side and on the currency side and commodities side, for which clearing is done mostly through CCIL, Clearing Corporation of India Limited. As of today, I feel that there will be a good growth in the derivatives market in India and the future looks bright. There is an increased focus on regulation. SEBI and RBI and also other regulators, for example IRDA, are ensuring that the market remains less risky and still people have availability of the various products in the derivatives market. New products are likely to come up. For example, credit default swaps are not much used in India. It is likely that once the bond market defaults, with the introduction of the Indian bond indices abroad, also something like CDS will come into play more and more. So we'll have more breadth and more depth in the derivatives market. This will help to identify better career options in the derivatives market if you have expertise in derivatives. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please like this video and share with your friends who will find this useful. Also, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. Cheers.